Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Woo! Coming up, we look at the recent updates to networking in Azure with the team's engineering leader, Yousef Khalidi, to highlight the areas of innovation, including leveraging Azure's network backbone to augment your WAN, new architectures for testing your network topologies, site acceleration, scaling out web workloads, and load balancing for content delivery with Azure CDN and Front Door, and securing workloads at the edge and across regions using Azure Web Application Firewall and DDoS protection. So please join me in welcoming the CVP of Networking in Azure, Yousef Khalidi.
Thank you for having me on the show.
It's great to have you. Thank you so much. So the network's really the key gateway to cloud services and getting your infrastructure apps and ultimately your users to connect to your resources. But how do you think of the role of the network in today's distributed architectures?
You know, nothing really matters if you cannot connect to the cloud. The quality of the connection in terms of latency, jitter, and bandwidth is very important. This always has been the case. You basically guys can't have a cloud without a network. We design, build, and operate one of the biggest wide area networks on the face of the earth. You can see some of the numbers here. We connect our 54 regions. We have more than 106 edge sites and increasing. I will say more about those in a second. We peer with so many ISPs out there that we have around 20,000 peering connections. And if you want to hear the punchline, every second on this WAN, we process 30 billion packets per second. 30 billion packets per second on the WAN. And that's not counting what we do within every region. So NetNet, we give you the ability to connect to the cloud through multiple means, through a huge scale, and we cater both to private and public connectivity to the cloud.
And we're continually making things faster and innovating as
all
we go
the
forward.
Time.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah. So attending Ignite, you see it.
Yeah, exactly, that's right. And the Azure network is powering some of the most demanding apps and services in the cloud. Can you tell us about some of the recent updates and what we're solving for with them?
Well, let's start with latency. Latency is very important to many of you and your customers. So when you access the cloud or even moving to cloud services in general, latency can be a huge inhibitor. The reason we have all these edge nodes is to make it much faster for you to get to your local regions. So we add these nodes in a strategic location around the globe. If you look at this map, we have them in the major metro areas. In the US, we start with NFL cities, then we grow. And we are adding more and more edge locations in Asia Pacific, Africa, Middle East, and so forth. The edge nodes is the way you get to Azure, the way you get to the Azure backbone, the WAN, which gets you to your region or regions around the globe. Now, it's not uncommon to see a big jump in performance once we place an Azure edge in a city somewhere. I can tell you there are some cases where latency improved by 2x to 10x by us putting an edge in a given city because we optimize the traffic and we get you to the fastest region for your application. In terms of performance, our North Star, we want to be able to get to 30 milliseconds or 35 milliseconds from any customer to the closest edge and to the closest region. Your mileage will vary, but 30 milliseconds is quite an aggressive goal. Excellent. We're getting there.
Yeah, we're getting there indeed. And so just to make this real, I'm going to quickly show you the difference here in a quick demo with three different connections. So this is a simulation of the user experience downloading the same file from three different services with caching turned off on all services. Now, the one on the left is being accelerated through Azure CDN. And you can see how much faster it is it returns versus the other two. In the middle is routing through a competing CDN service. And on the right, we're not using any form of acceleration over the open internet. So this clearly demonstrates the native acceleration capabilities of our network, which is incredibly impressive. So Yousef, can you help us understand what we've done here to ensure that this incredible app delivery and experience for amazing app performance within the Microsoft WAN?
As you know, CDNs cache content. They cache files, video, web assets, and so forth. We cache them on servers on those edge locations I mentioned earlier. The system fetches the data from the origins, from a region somewhere, from storage, for example, and puts them on the edge. And then your device, your phone, your PC, then gets that content from the very closest edge to you. For years, we've had our own internal CDN that all of us used if you're using Windows Update or Xbox or the marketplace, et cetera. Now we've added this CDN, also to our complete CDN offerings. So today, we have three CDN systems, the Microsoft system. We have partnerships with Verizon, and we have partnerships with Akamai. And through that, you end up with a big, huge global coverage. Just look at the picture you see on the screen at the moment.
Awesome. Now, what are some of the options that I have as an architect or perhaps a developer then to leverage this Azure global network to improve the performance and connectivity?
If you think of Microsoft's global presence, we have services that allow you to connect locally near your users into Azure and to benefit from our WAN. That's always been our strategy. So if you connect to the cloud through the internet, another great option would be to use a new service we announced today, which is the Microsoft Peering Service. How this works is basically we have partnered with many ISPs out there, internet service providers, to have the best optimized connectivity between our edge locations and their networks. It's effectively a business class internet. And when you sign up for it, we get continuous monitoring of your connectivity. We give you reports and help to remediate any problems or anomalies you might see. And in the Azure portal, you see telemetry and monitoring of your connections between your sites and Microsoft, such as latency profile of any given prefix of your network that we are monitoring using the Microsoft services peering service. Today, we monitor over 20 million routes on the internet. With this service, though, we now give you the ability to see if any of your routes are being dropped by your ISP, or worse, if somebody's trying to hijack your route. And moreover, we protect you from that. So if someone was able to advertise a route away from your ISP, we don't obey it. Instead, we continue serving your traffic, and we tell you something has gone wrong.
OK, so for those of us who've been in the network architecture space for a while and have got a reliable, high-performing network, but want to make things run even better, how can people do that?
Well, one way we can do that is with a new service we just announced called Internet Analyzer. It helps you to assess the right approach for delivering content from the cloud.
OK. Should we take a quick look?
Please.
I've got it on here. Yeah. OK, we can take a look. So you can see I've got two network topologies here, one in Azure in the top of the blade there, and one in another cloud. And Internet Analyzer basically lets me A-B test delivery architectures before you port your services over. So it gives you a view of where you're coming from alongside where you're going to. And this is a measure of what the user experience is. So you get some great visibility into that last mile connection, as Yousef was talking about. So setting up a test is actually really easy. So if I move over to the middle here in the test area, I simply give it a name. I want to obviously embed my client-side JavaScript in my app first to get the measurements running, but we provide a name, a description for the test, and then we can start to configure the endpoint. And you'll see here, I'm going to click on this first endpoint A and configure it. And you can see you can use both our pre-configured and there are custom endpoint options as well for your testing. So I'm going to give this one a name as Azure Single Region. The endpoint type is, in this case, Azure Single Region. As you see, I could have used custom there as well. The Azure region in my case is West US, and I'm going to use front door as well. So very quickly, I've configured the endpoints, and I can start kicking off that testing. It's all really, really straightforward. But what's happening under the covers here?
Well, we're actually measuring performance. Your client is measuring the performance of latency from your end user population to your selected network destination. And it does this by downloading one pixel image over HTTPS. Then this telemetry data is sent to Internet Analyzer in Azure, and ultimately provided back to you to help you to understand the performance and benefits of a multitude of network topologies and different paths to your application. We just announced this thing in preview this week, so please go give it a try. It's really very easy to use.
Great. Now, networking, as many people know, can be tricky, and sometimes you need to reroute traffic, or maybe a connection just gets saturated.
Yep.
So what are we doing there to help with app delivery and acceleration?
These are very common questions and needs, if you will. And of course, we build a service for that, too. It's called Azure Front Door. It's a service we've had in Microsoft for a while, and now it's available to you as well. The service lets you define and manage, monitor, and optimize your web traffic for performance, and to automatically fail over, if needed, for high availability. So Front Door works at layer 7. HTTP layer, basically, and uses any CAS protocol to find the closest edge to your customer, if you will. And then it will optimize the traffic from that edge to your origin in Azure. We do things like split TCP, so the connection is terminated at the edge, and we multiplex over common TCP connections. We do also other optimizations as well.
Okay, so that's going to give better performance for the app, but what about the security side? What have we done there?
As I mentioned at the very beginning, is performance and security are really very important.
Yeah.
So our goal in Azure Network Security is basically to deploy defense in depth. And we've built our services on the concept of effectively zero trust, where you're minimizing the entities that trust each other, and you want to sort of have macro parameters, micro segmentation, if you will, across highly distributed architectures. So for example, we have the web app firewall. It protects web pages, layer 7, against common exploits. We've had this for a while within the virtual network in the cloud. Now we recently launched WAF also at the edge. So you can combine WAF functions at the edge and WAF functions within your virtual network as well. And as you probably know, web apps are often targeted with attacks such as SQL injection, cross-site scripting, layer 7 DDoS. So we built in these protections all the way, as I mentioned, from the edge to the application you have. And if you haven't configured this one lately, again, it's relatively easy to use. Please try it.
And best of all, it's really easy to get going. So
really,
should we take a look?
Great, yeah, actually,
So we've got it on the screen here. So here we are in the Create a WAF Policy blade within the Azure portal. And I'm just going to give this one some basic information. You see I've given it a name already. Choose some other basic information, subscription, resource group, the usual stuff, very familiar. But next, I can go on to the policy settings and firstly select whether this is a prevention or detection WAF policy. And then I'm into essentially configuring some of my rules. And in first case, I'm looking at specific managed rules that are based on the core rule set from the Open Web Application Security Project, or OWASP. I'm sure that's familiar to many of you. And these rules give a baseline to protect against common threats. And you can see I can make some modifications if I want. So I'm blocking currently, but I can change that action to logging if I prefer. So make some customization. You can also see that I've got bot protection in preview here too, so for additional managed rules. And I can also create custom rules to augment the existing managed rule sets. And in this case, I'm going to create a simple geolocation rule that blocks traffic not originating from the US. So I make a few changes there, choose the US, and within a few clicks, we're done. And once that's finished, I can associate these to, for instance, Azure Front Door resources. So in this case, I've selected a Front Door demo, and then the front-end host, and click Add, and I'm done. Look at the review, validate the settings that I've made, make sure I've done it all correctly, and then I could go ahead and click Create. So really easy stuff, very, very powerful, but very, very straightforward at the same time. And this is where, again, the advantage of our global network comes into play.
Definitely. You need size. You need the ability to handle a lot of bandwidth, because frankly, when a global DDoS attack happens, you need a lot of capacity to absorb the traffic and send it to the right place. So it's the same infrastructure we have built to support Microsoft services such as Xbox and Office 365. And now they're also available to you in our DDoS service.
Exactly. Incredible stuff. Now, you're protected. You can check in regularly to set up alerts and see what the bad guys are doing. And there's been a lot of news lately about running Azure services on any infrastructure, whether that's in your data center, at the edge, in IoT, or in other clouds. So this sounds like it's fundamentally enabled by the network. So what else are we doing to better support these new hybrid topologies?
Oh, we have a new service, actually. So we're building new service solutions that take one of our edge devices where you can place it directly on the customer premises. And it's combined with networking. We call it multi-access edge compute. Some folks call them mobile edge compute. But basically, on top of that, we'll add extended Azure functionality, such as support for containers, IoT, and virtual machines, beyond core networking, if you will. And we will provide extended capabilities for many, many locations with centralized remote management and the ability to develop software from the cloud onto those boxes. The best part is they'll be able to all tap into very low latency 5G cellular technology, such as private LTE or CBRS, if you're familiar with those technologies. So I like to think of the network really as the key to any hybrid configuration. So as we deliver more and more against the promise of Azure on any infrastructure, of course, you'd be thinking of the best way to connect and keep everything secure.
OK, so the big question, when will this be available?
We just announced a technical preview, which is happening as we speak. We'll be opening it up more broadly in the next calendar year.
Excellent. Awesome. Thank you so much, Yousef. And great highlights across recent announcements for all the networking stuff in Azure. And a lot of this is ready to start using today. You know, just click on the plus sign in the Azure portal to get started. Where can we learn more?
We have many opportunities for you to know more. We will continue innovation at the edge, global scale, and so forth. And if you would like to know more, the link on the screen will give you more information. I have a blog published at this link. And at Ignite, we have more than a dozen sessions that are going to be archived available for you to view as well.
Excellent. Yeah, make sure you check those out. Lots of valuable information. And check out the blog, as Yousef said. So thank you again so much for joining.
Thank you
so much. It's been a pleasure to have you. And keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for all the latest updates. Subscribe. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, guys.